I'll tell you. Protect me, God. I turn to you for help. I profess you are my Lord, my greatest good. I once put faith in false gods, the idols of the land. Now I make no offering to them, nor invoke their names. Those who chase after them add grief upon grief. Lord, you measure out my portion, the shape of my future. You mark off the best place for me to enjoy my inheritance. I bless God who teaches me, who schools my heart even at night. I am sure God is here right beside me. I cannot be shaken. So my heart rejoices, my body thrills with life, my whole being rests secure. You will not abandon me to Sheol, nor send your faithful one to death. You show me the road to life, boundless joy at your side forever.
Forever I will thank you.
Rejoice with Jerusalem and be glad with her, all you who love her. Rejoice with her, all you who mourn for her, that you may feed and be satisfied with the consolation of her bosom, that you may drink deeply and be delighted with the abundance of her glory. For thus says the Lord, behold, I will extend peace to her like a river, and the glory of the Gentiles like a flowing stream. Then you shall feed. On her sides shall you be carried and be dandled on her knees.
Thank you.
For you are called to freedom, brothers and sisters. Only do not use your freedom as an opportunity for self-indulgence, but through love, become slaves to one another. For the whole law is summed up in a single commandment: you shall love your neighbor as yourself. Spirit, I say, and do not gratify the desires of the flesh. For what the flesh desires is opposed to the spirit, and what the spirit desires is opposed to the flesh. For these are opposed to each other, to prevent you from doing what you want. But if you are led by the spirit, you are not subject to the law. Now the works of the flesh are obvious. Crucified the flesh with its passions and desires. And if we live by the Spirit, let us also be guided by the Spirit.